Now, next month, Australia will be among the favourites at this year's Eurovision Song Contest in Sweden.
That's right, and our very own Dami Im will be flying the flag in Stockholm, hoping to win a place in the final on May 15th with this song.
Keep calling, calling, and I keep calling, calling, keep calling.
That's just a little clip of what we're going to be expecting to hear at Eurovision. The wonderful Dami Im joins us now in the News Breakfast studio. Good morning, Dami.
Good morning.
Welcome to News Breakfast.
Oh, thank you.
Good morning.
So it's not long now before Eurovision. How are you feeling?
Oh, I'm getting more nervous by each day. So I'm flying out this Saturday, so really it's coming so soon, and I've got to represent the country, so there is a little bit of pressure.
No, you'll do that task wonderfully, I'm sure. How do you prepare for Eurovision? What have you been doing to get ready?
Oh, just, I had to do so many things, Michael. You know, from getting the right song and, you know, making the videos and just working out what I'm going to do on stage in terms of costume, the stage design, my movement. And then, of course, there's so many, you know, press and interviews that I have to do for Eurovision. So it's just been so busy in this process.
Yeah, you mentioned one of those things to get ready was actually having the right song. How do you feel about this particular song choice, The Sound of Silence?
You know, I really love this song, and I mean, I might be biased, but the song is about feeling, you know, distant from your loved ones, and I really feel I can relate to that when I'm in hotel rooms and I miss, you know, my love Noah, and I'm like, you know, that's what the song is about. Mm. So yeah, I really like the song, and also there's, you know, a chance for me to really showcase what I can do vocally, so I think that's important.
A lot of people in the know are tipping some great things for you at Eurovision, even perhaps going near the top of the grand final runoff. Does that make you feel even more nervous?
I think it's really flattering. There's 40-something countries, and for people to even consider me as somebody, you know, at the top of the rank, I'm just very honoured and flattered, but I just feel like I have to give it my everything for this one performance.
Because you only get one go, that's it, don't you? It's a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
This time it's different, because I know last year Guy Sebastian was our entrance and he went straight to the grand final. But this time you actually have to compete in the semi-final, don't you?
Yeah,
get to the grand final and then from there. But look, like Michael said, the betting odds are in your favour. They're saying you're going to be number three. It's pretty good.
I hope people follow that up with votes, because I do have to get enough votes and then get to the grand final. So, fingers crossed.
Yeah. Don't worry, we'll be right behind you. Now, you've got a new album. You're putting a new album out based on the fabulous work of the Carpenters, in particular Karen Carpenter, who was a great hit back in the 1970s. We can hear a bit of it now. Why did you choose Karen Carpenter?
Oh, my parents were big Carpenters fans, and they used to play me their song, I mean, the Carpenters songs when I was in the car, you know, going to school, and then I loved their tunes, and I just thought, well, they're such beautiful songs. People don't write such beautiful songs anymore sometimes, well, these days, I feel like, and I thought, why don't I bring them back and just, you know, perform these wonderful, timeless tunes in my own style.
So you've taken the Carpenter songs, and of course it's a cover, so you've put your own twist to it. Is there any particular song that really stands out to you?
Oh, it's a really hard question. I love every single track. They're just masterpieces. But I have to say, I do love Close to You. It just makes me so happy.
It's one of my favourites.
And you're belting out a great rendition of it just then as well. She was fabulous. Of course, she had a bit of a tragic life in the end, Karen Carpenter, but at her peak, she was, you know, a global superstar.
Yeah, and her voice was just, you know, magical, so pure, and I just love how she was just natural, you know, and just herself and focusing on the musical side of everything. I just love that about her.
So you're off to Eurovision this weekend, then you come back, you have this album out, and you're also touring Australia. Is there anything you're not doing, Dami, at the moment?
Well, I'm not getting enough exercise, so that's something I should think about.
So on behalf of all of us here at Breakfast, and I know I speak on behalf of every Australian watching, all the best, Dami. I know you'll knock them dead.
Go and get them. Just do your best and we're all right behind you.
Oh, thank you so much. That makes me feel really good.
Good luck.
Go get
them. Thank you.
And it's hashtag Dami Army, just in case you're wondering, if you're on social media.
I'll be singing along. Actually, that's probably not a good thing to do, but...
yeah, maybe not.
Now.